I've known this next lady since she was about four. She was practically singing before she could walk. She started in church with a God-given talent. In my book, she's number one, the queen of soul. But alas, it's sales that count, so number four it is.
Aretha Franklin epitomized what we thought soul meant. The things, the runs she could do with her voice and the way she could sustain her notes and run across chords. Ugh, just unbelievable.
I'm not a star. I'm the lady next door.
Well, Aretha is still a...
Aretha Franklin's dad was a celebrity minister. Albums of his sermons were top sellers in Detroit, and he encouraged her to sing in church.
When you leave your church, you go home and you listen to the radio, and one of the highlights of a Sunday was listening to Reverend C.L. Franklin, and you'd be waiting to see if Aretha was going to sing.
The child prodigy was an early developer on all fronts. Aretha had two illegitimate kids before she was 17.
She had some children very young, so she might be one of these people who sort of never had a sort of a real childhood or even a real teenagerhood. She was a working professional from very early on.
And Dad didn't approve when early success seemed to go to her head.
He said, "Why aren't you helping to clean this house?" I said, "I'm a star. I'm not supposed to do that. I've been to New York."
Away from the big city, a low-key recording session confirmed the magnitude of Aretha's talent.
It was my notion to take her to a small town in Alabama called Muscle Shoals, just the quiet, sleepy ambience of the Deep South. No distractions.
Working with me at every recording session is engineer Tom Dowd.
The musicians, when they'd walk in, they'd say, "Man, you gotta hear this chick. I mean, we made the bad, she sings like a bird."
But Aretha had as many problems as gifts.
We recorded for one night. Everything went crazy. Fights and screaming and doors slamming, and maybe there were shots being fired, I don't know.
The problem was her tempestuous marriage, although husband Ted White also inspired some of her greatest work.
You're no good, heartbreaker. You're a liar and you're a cheat.
If she's being abused or if she is not comfortable, that's when she sings her heart out. Because that's the only way she can let out the pain, the anguish, the hurt.
Don't play that song for me, because it brings back memories of days that I once knew.
Inevitably, the stormy marriage came to an end. She divorced White after their battles became unbearable. The result was a happier, more independent Aretha.
I'm no longer doubtful of what I'm living for. And if I make you happy, I don't need to do more. Because you make me feel, you make me feel, you.
After two failed marriages and myriad romances, Aretha's still looking for Mr. Right.
A real man is not going to be intimidated by me.
Men rise to the occasion.
Talking of real men.
Ladies and gentlemen, the most nicest and the most exciting thing I know, Aretha Franklin.
But there was more pain to come. Aretha's father was shot, fell into a coma, and finally died in 1984. She returned with a new sound and a new look. Not everyone approved.
And I said, Aretha, you do not have to sing one more song to prove that you can still sing. All you have to do is play one of your old records against what these people think is good. It's chopped liver. It's garbage.
Since then, Aretha's only bothered with the occasional cameo appearance. These days, George is out of the closet, while Aretha barely comes out of her front door.
She's not a recluse, but she's, I guess you could say, a little bit like that.
Typical day would be soap operas from about 12 to 3 or 4 o'clock.
I'm a domestic goddess at home.
Her latest passion is gardening.
I'm just raring to get home and get in all this dirt and stuff.
She's one of those people who's come through the other side of that success in the 60s and really found a stable life. I think she's probably happier now than she's probably ever been.
This next group had it all.